Hi, this is Comp 1010 at the University of Manitoba. I'm Dr. Celine LaTulip, and today I'm going to be talking to you about Boolean operators. So there are six operators that we call relational operators in processing and Java. And these look similar to the math symbols that you've seen before. So we have less than and greater than, less than or equal to and greater than or equal to. And we have a not equal sign, which is similar to the not equal sign in math. But this one here is kind of special. We have equals equals. And this is a test for equality operator in programming. And it's treated the way an equal sign is in math. It says, does this, what's on the left, equal what's on the right? And the reason we use equal equal here is because a single equal sign in processing and in Java and in many other programming languages is used for assignment. So you've seen things like, let me get my pen here, x equals 5. And that assigns the value 5 into the variable x, and that's a single equal sign. And so we can't use this to test for equality when we're already using it for assignment. And so it's really important to note that we use a double equal sign to test for equality. So all of these relational operators require that we have Boolean variables, that we have numeric variables on either side, and we get a Boolean result. So let's look at a couple of examples. And the numeric values can be any of the numerics that we're used to, ints, longs, floats, or doubles. And we can have an operator on either side of these expressions just as a variable, as a literal, or as an expression. So let's look at some examples. Here we have two literals, 5 less than 6. And so 5 is less than 6. This is true. And so the result of this expression is true. Here we have x equals equals 7. So this is a test of equality. We're saying, does whatever's in the variable x equal 7? And the result of whether this is true or false depends on what's stored in x. Here we have a couple of expressions, mathematical expressions. So 2 times 3. And we're testing to see that whether or not that is not equal to 5 times 1. So 2 times 3 is 6. 6 is not equal to 5. And so this turns out to be true, right? And here we have some floats that we're comparing. And so is it true that 7.5 is greater than 2.0 times 4.5? Well, this would give 9.0. Is 7.5 greater than 9.0? No, so this would give us false. Okay, so those are examples of using relational operators. Again, we can have literals or variables or expressions on either side of these relational operators, but they've got to be numeric, and the result we get is Boolean. Okay, so how do we use this stuff in code? We've had a pen drawing example in processing where we draw lines from old XY to new XY, and we can control this actually better using the mouse pressed in the if statement that we just talked about. So we can look at this. Right now we only draw when we've got the mouse button pressed. Okay, but we can also do things like change the fill color depending on where we are on the canvas using relational operators. So if we want to draw red in the top half of the canvas, but the pen to draw green in the bottom half, then we need to check whether our mouse coordinate is in the top half of the canvas. And so we need the relational operator here. So we can put this in. If mouse Y is less than height divided by 2, then we do stroke, and we want it to be red, so 25500. Else, if we're not in the top half of the canvas, we're in the bottom half of the canvas, so then we want the stroke to be green, so 02550. Okay, so let's run that. And now if we're drawing up here, we've got red. If we're drawing down here, we've got green. And if we draw across the middle of the canvas, you can see that this changes. Okay, so that makes sense. And here we've got mouse Y, which is a numeric, compared to another numeric, and we get a Boolean result. It's either true or false. Now, if we want to do something more interesting, what if we want to only draw green when we're in the bottom right corner? Well, that gets a little bit messy because now we have to check two different things. Are we on the right side and are we on the bottom? And so the way that we need to do this is we need some fancier Boolean expressions, and that's the right way to do it. So let's look at our Boolean operators. So just like we can have plus and minus and multiply and divide with math, we can have and, or not with Booleans as the inputs and the result. So let's have a look at these. So the Boolean operator and says X and Y, and this is going to take a Boolean on the left side and a Boolean on the right side, and it's going to give us a Boolean result, and the Boolean will be true if both of these are true. Okay, so the result of an AND operator is true if X is true and Y is true. And we have a truth table over here that tells us what this looks like. So here's X, what X is, here's what Y is, and there's four combinations. So if X and Y are true, then X and Y is true. If X is true and Y is false, then X and Y is false. If X is false and Y is true, then X and Y is false. And if they're both false, then X and Y is false. So the only way we get a true result from a logical AND operator is when both of the inputs are actually true, okay? And then we have the OR operator, and the OR says that the result is true if X is true or if Y is true. It's also true if they're both true. So let's look at the truth table for that. So here we have X and Y are true, the result is true. Here we have X is true, Y is false, but it is true that X or Y is true. And here we have the opposite, X is false and Y is true. So X or Y is true because Y is true. The only case where we get a false here is if both X and Y are false, then X or Y is false. Next, we have the negation operator, which is an exclamation mark. And so not X, when we put the negation operator in it, if X is true, it becomes, the result is false. If X is false, the result is true. All right, so let's look at some examples of this. Here we have if score is greater than or equal to 0 and score is less than or equal to 10. And so this basically allows us to check that a number is in between these two ranges, right? And both of these things have to be true for the score to be between 0 and 10. Here we're checking to see if the mouse is over on the left or if the game has just started. And if either of those are true, then the whole thing becomes true. And here we're saying, is it false that an error happened? And are things still valid? So this will end up being true if there's no errors and still valid is true. So all of those things above, those sort of what we call compound expressions, can be put inside of an if statement. So we could do something like if score is greater than or equal to 0 and score is less than or equal to 10, then go and do something. But we could also store the results of an expression like this into a Boolean variable. So Boolean valid score equals score greater than or equal to 0 and score is less than or equal to 10. And this will either be true or false. And then we can use that later on in our code and just test whether what's in here is true or false. And if it's true, then we can do the stuff inside of this if block. Okay, so now we have mathematical operators and relational operators and the Boolean operators. And so we have to revisit our order of operations. So the first thing we're going to do is any sub-expression, stuff in parentheses gets done first. Then we're going to do the unary operator. So this is like negating things or doing the incrementing or decrementing, but also negation, the logical negation of a Boolean. Then we do our binary operators. So multiplicative, additive, and then we do the relational, and then we do tests for equality or not equals. And finally, the logical operations come last. And all of that then will get assigned to some variable if we're using it that way. So now we have all these different operators, and it can get a little bit hard to understand. So look at this. A is less than B plus C, or A equals equals zero, and with C less than 10. It's really hard when you look at this to say, like, oh my gosh, what are we doing and what happens first? So if you use parentheses, you can actually make this much more readable and we can see what's happening first. And so this actually preserves the order of operations. So this is actually identical to what's up here, but it's really a lot more clear what's going on, right? So we are doing this and we're ORing it with this at the end. First, we have to figure out what this is, then we have to figure out what this is, and then we have to figure out how this ANDs with that to give us what's inside these parentheses. We have over here, we have to do the plus, and then we have to do the relation, and then we figure out what this is, and we do it ORed with what we figured out over here. So it's a lot more clear in the second example what order to do things in because of the parentheses. All right, so let's go back to our pen drawing where we want to draw in green only in the bottom right corner, otherwise draw in red. And there's a few different ways to do this. So we can check if we're in the bottom right corner by doing a logical AND here. So we check if the mouse X is greater than the width over 2, which means that we're over on the right hand side of the canvas, and that mouse Y is greater than height over 2, which means we're in the bottom of the canvas. So this means that we're in the right and the bottom. And in that case, we fill with green. And if that's not true, the else says fill with red. Okay. Or we could do something like this, where we actually put parentheses around the whole thing. So this is basically, it's exactly the same thing, but we're making it clear because we're putting parentheses around each part, which shows us that we've got to do this part first, and then this part, and then we AND it. Whereas up here, you might think, oh, I have to AND width over 2 and mouse Y. And so this just makes this a little bit more readable, but it's otherwise exactly the same. You could also do the opposite. You could check that we're not in the bottom right corner and set the fill color to red. So here, if mouse X is less than or equal to width over 2, so this means we're in the left half of the canvas, or if mouse is less than or equal to height over 2, which means we're in the top half of the canvas, if either of those things is true, which is why we have the OR operator, then we're gonna fill things with red. Otherwise, we're gonna fill with green. And this again is the same thing written slightly differently just because we're adding in the parentheses to make it clear what has to happen first. And then we could also do this thing at the top, but negate the entire thing. So this says we're in the bottom right corner. If this is true and this is true, we're in the bottom right corner. So we could say if we're not in the bottom right corner by putting this negation around the whole thing, then we fill with red. Otherwise, this means we are in the bottom right corner, so fill with green. So there's many different ways that you can code this. I say stick to the thing that's sort of simplest and makes most sense to you. So adding an extra negation is usually, there's usually not a good reason for that. And adding parentheses helps make it clear. So I would probably go with this example right here. So let's put that into our processing code. So here we have, we want to change this to be if mouse X is greater than width divided by 2 and mouse Y is greater than height divided by 2, then we want to draw red. And so I've got these mixed up. Otherwise, we want to draw green. Okay, is that, have I got it correct? Or did I just, I think I just messed it up. I've got the colors were right the first time. Okay, so we're only drawing green when we're in the bottom corner, otherwise we're drawing red. So let's run this and see how it works. All right, so we're drawing green. And oops, I think we've done it wrong because now we're drawing red. So we've got these, we do have these mixed up. So 0, 2, 5, 5, and 2. And now we're drawing red everywhere except the bottom corner right where we're drawing green. Okay, and so this is a use of compound Boolean expressions. We check that this is true and this is true. If they're both true, then we draw green. If either of them is false, we're going to end up drawing red. Okay, so it's important that you only do one of these and you don't do multiple checks when you don't need to. So you could do something like this. If we do that, and then you do if, and you do the opposite, right? And we say otherwise less than or equal to, less than or equal to, or, so this does the, this is the opposite of the check, and then we draw red. So here we've got red, here we've got red, and over here we've got green. But really, this is not necessary, and it's more code and more chances for error because the only possibilities we have are that we're in the bottom right corner or we're not. And if we're not in the bottom right corner, we want to draw red. And so making this just be else is a lot simpler and more straightforward and avoids us making a lot of errors because we might screw up some of these compound conditions or we might change our mind about exactly what we're doing and then there's more code to change. Okay, so that's it for compound Boolean expressions and Boolean operators. Thanks for watching.